בעזרת השם, we'll begin learning Sefer Zer Shimshon. This is every Wednesday from 9 to 10, 1 hour. בעזרת השם, why we're learning Zer Shimshon? Because Rabbi Shimshon ben Nachmani said, whoever learns my Sefer from Shamayim, I'll pray for him and I will bring Zuchut on him. Means Hashem will do miracles because of this tzaddik. He will pray for us and he's known to do a lot of miracles. A lot of people see miracles, including me and including our congregants, and Baruch Hashem, since we see a lot of miracles, we want more miracles. So we want this tzaddik to be praying for us, and Beis Hashem, through learning this book, we should have growth. Yes. In Torah, mitzvot, ma'asim tovim, v'chein yiratzon l'mar. Yitalel ha-mitalel v'yadu ha-sechel l'isa b'racha me'et Hashem v'lilmod midat kono l'atchil kol ma'asav v'remes ha-romez l'ashon b'racha ki sham yitzave Adonai oto ito et ha-bracha b'racha v'chaim ad ha-olam. וכן מעשינו במדרש ילקוט, למה התחילה התורה בבית, שהוא לשון ברכה? It's obvious question that since Aleph Bet starts with Aleph, so let's begin the Torah with Aleph. Why Hashem begins Torah? אלה דקשה, שערי קרא כתיב, because the pasuk says, ראש דברך אמת, תהלים, in 119, David HaMelech said, Hashem, Rosh Dvarcha Emet. From the beginning of your Torah is already Emet. How? If you see the last letters, Bereshit after Bereshit, Bara Aleph, Elohim Mem, Et Tav, Aleph Mem, Tav is Emet, last letters. So, David HaMelech said, beginning of your words is already Emet. Vim Ken, Hayal Latchil, Atorah Be'Aleph. So if beginning of the Torah is Emet, truth, so let's begin the Torah with Aleph. Why the Torah starts with Bet? Shehu Lashon Emet, it's Emet. Somebody says, Hashem Elokechem Emet, Emet, right? V'agam ki bereshit, bara Elohim et, bara, lastly is Aleph. Elohim is Mem, Et is Tav. Aleph Mem, Tav is Emet. In the beginning, Torah stands for Emet. So if Torah starts with Emet, so start Torah with Aleph. Why start Torah with Bet? Question repeats. Im kol zeh, haya min ha-ra'u she'od ha-lishona shel ha-Torah tiyeh be-emet. Kedeh le-kayem rosh dvar ha-emet be-davka. So David HaMelech says in Tehillim, Hashem, from beginning your Torah is Emet. So let's start with Aleph. Why starting with Bet? That is the question. Ba'af ki itchil ba'bet shu lashon bracha. Why Torah starts bet? Because it's bracha, yeah? It's blessing. Im kol ze, eno mitkayem rosh dvarcha emet. So if you're starting from bracha, so where's the rosh dvarcha emet? From beginning Torah is emet. You don't have that. If you want to start Torah properly, start with Aleph. Because David HaMelech says what? In the beginning your Torah is Emet. So to write Emet you need Aleph. So if it's important Aleph, so why do you start with Bet? Oh, Bet is Bracha. Yeah, but what happened with Aleph? Aleph is Emet. Why not? Losh Dvarcha Emet should be Emet. So why not starting with Aleph? Ve'esh Lomar is giving the answer. Da Amrina B'Midrash Rabba Parashat Tazria. It says in Parashat Tazria, Emen Shelema V'Tzedek Yelach. If you are honest in your weighing things as a salesman, you know, people sell objects. Let's say you put 5 apples, right? And you say 5 apples, 2 pounds. Person turns around, you take 1 apple away. Or you have 5 apples, but you don't have a stone there that holds for 2 pounds. You have a 1 pound and 750 grams, not 2 pounds. No, we have a rule here. Before we enter here, it's off. So what happens when a person doesn't have
2 pounds and says 1.75, then he's stealing. So Torah says, Evan Shalemah, whoever is honest, Betzedeg Yelach. If a person is honest, he will have a mercy of Hashem on him. Hashem says, Betzedeg, the righteousness will be with you. If person is honest, he will have what to take, what to give, what to sell, what to buy. Shabrachot mevarchot et ba'alein, because blessings bless the owner. When person is honest, the blessing is over his head. Bechen lehefech. And same thing is opposite. If person is blessed, blessing is on his head. You know what honest thing is? Honest thing is, I know why he promises, if you learn his sefer, he will make you miracle. Because he takes your brain and makes it work. And he wants your brain to be able to learn a chidush. Not learn. Be able to come up with your own chidush. Once you work hard to make your brain process a chidush and take out new chidush, then Hashem gives you bracha. Then Hashem says, you know what? You did this, I'll be making you a miracle. Because you're taking your brain and you're working hard to make a chidush. We'll come out with such a chidush right now, you all will have fun. But let's have patience. So if person is blessed, all the brachot on his head, chas v'sham lo aleinu. If person is not honest, he sells 4 apples, person turns around and takes 3 apples, right? Haklalot mekalot et ba'alein, chas v'shalom, person gets curses on his head. Now, the mashma mikan, she'im yitnaeg ha'adam betzedek ve'emet, tiyeh lo ha'baracha. So from here comes out, if person is dealing with tzedek, truthfulness, righteousness, and emet, and the truthfulness, tiyeh lo ha'baracha. So if person has truthfulness, he's gonna have blessing. If person has righteousness, he's gonna have blessing. What does that mean? If not, then opposite. If he's not truthfulness, then he's not blessing. Im ken, shapir kamar kro. Ah, he says, if like this, if person is truthful, he has blessing, then Torah makes sense. Torah makes sense, why? Because Torah says, rosh dvarcha emet. The beginning of your Torah is emet. 1 second, what is the beginning of the Torah? Beracha, blessing. The beginning is bracha, right? It says, that is emet. Why? Because if you are emet, then it's bracha. It's a sword with 2 edges. Hashem's beginning of your Torah is true. Why? Because I see bracha here.
What is the bracha? It's
not shalom. Tell me the first pasuk in the Torah. Why it says Bereshit?
So why?
1 second.
Why baracha? Why no other different words from bed?
Very good. Midrash says Torah starts with. You know what I'll tell you? Let's read the second 3-4 lines. You'll see the answer. What's Bereshit stands for? No. What's Bereshit stands for? Break it up. Bereshit. What does that stand for? What stands for? What? Bedishon achat shloshim yom tipadeh. That's one of them. What is Bereshit here stands for? Here. He's gonna say it now. I don't wanna say it because I want him to say it. But you know what it stands for? Rosh Bet. You know what Rosh Bet is? Rosh is Rosh Bet. There's no emet. There's bracha there. What are you talking about? He says, yeah, bracha comes when there's emet. When there's emet, there's bracha. You want to say, where you got that word from? Where you see bracha? Let's go further. He's going to give you 20 cases. You're not gonna miss it, believe me. You're going to come out from here. At least one you get. I don't even think that we're going to get all of them today. But at least one we get, you will see that it all makes sense. It's Zerah Shimshon. It's not Yosef Akil. Listen, it would be mine. You take the pshat road to the garbage. It's Zerah Shimshon we're talking about. Let's go. This is mine? Thank you. I still have my tea, this is why I don't make bracha. Okay. Demashma mikan. She'im yitnahega adam betzedek ve'emet. If person is honest and truthful, tiyelo abracha. Simple. Where's the bracha? When there is honesty, there's bracha. Simple. Is that clear? Let's go.
ואם לאו חס ושום להפך, בדפנת חס ושום פרסן גצפור. כלל חס ושום. אם כן, שפיר כאמר קרוא. If so, then Torah makes sense. The point is, where do you got the word bracha from? And you got the word emet from. If it's emet, so then why bracha? If there's bracha, why there's emet? So what's the connection? So it gives you connection. Rosh dvarcha emet, from beginning your Torah is emet Hashem. Why? Do you see emet? Where is emet? Okay, bara Elohim et. Bereshit, bara aleph, last letter, Elohim. Last letter, mem, et, taf. That's emet. Sheitchil bebet, shehu lashon beracha. Why Torah starts with bet? That lashon beracha. Where you got beracha from? Lefi shezo ena nitenet ele lemi shedover emet bilvavo. A person will never have bracha. Why you get the word bracha from bet? Betzedek, what's the word bracha? Bet. Come on. Binyamin, whatever is this? Whatever. Where you got bracha from? He says, there's no time in the world person will have bracha unless he has shoot. You see, he says one more word. Bilvavo. What means bilvavo? When you know Hashem is one. I'll tell you chidush I learned today. I learned one chidush. It will change your life thinking for the whole world. Are you ready? Tell me two first psukim in the Torah. Bereshit, go. One second. Bereshit bara. Et hashamayim ve'et haaretz. Ve'aretz ha'ita. Tov avohu, tochka. What did you understand from here?
That Hashem created light.
In the beginning, Hashem created heaven and earth, and then what? And the land was? Or, let's learn it simple way, empty. You know what? Let me show you how our rabbis learned. How our rabbis learned before. They said like this, Bereshit bara Elohim et ha-shamayim ve'et ha-aretz. If you learning the Torah in the beginning, Hashem created everything, then what? Then in the world, there's nothing there.
In the world, there's nothing there?
Well, no, Nathaniel smiles. You know why? He got it! There's a deep shot here.
Nathaniel has to look for.
Oh!
If you're learning Torah.
You don't care about nothing in the world. Why? Because you're running after the Creator. There's nothing there but Him. Bereshit bara Elohim et ha-shamayim ve'et ha'aretz ve'al zayit ha-tohu v'avohu. If you are true Oved Hashem, you don't care about jewelry, diamond, gold. You sit. You find whatever parents you need for family, then you go back to your learning. You go to search for Hashem. Ve'al zayit ha-tohu v'avohu.
Nothing. The land was good. And
since you're all here.
Okay, good point.
You always dispute.
You want to hear something? What Tohu Vavohu stands for? This is one of the diamonds that not everybody has. So I want to share with you. If I find it, yes. If not, then oh, I found it. Yes. You stopped?
No, it's recording.
This is $1 million, Shani. Kidding me? This is you're not gonna find anywhere. I tell you. What Tohu Vavohu stands for? Romes al Galud Mitzrayim. Already. In the beginning of the creation of the world, Hashem says, you know what? One day there will be Galut Mitzrayim. How do you know this? Where do you know from? Make sure I have this recording. Look what it says here. Tohu Vavohu stands for Vechol Habat Techayun. That is Tohu. What Paro said? If it's a girl, let her leave. Right? Yeah. What's Vavohu? Im. Ben hu vahamiten. Va vo hu. In ben hu vahamiten. But if it's a boy, kill him. Tohu vavohu. Hashem already knew what Paro will say. Paro will say, if it's a girl, let her leave. Boy, throw him, kill him. Tohu vavohu. At the beginning already, Tohu vavohu was known. Okay, let's go further. Now. If person will look with the magnifying glass in the word Bereshit, ha'otiyot shelahem Rosh Bet. The letters over there is Rosh Bet. What? Beginning, Rosh, the head,
is bet. V'hainu means rosh kmo rosh devar ha'emet. What is rosh?
Continuing.
V'hainu rosh kmo rosh devar ha'emet. Rosh is in the beginning. Your Torah is emet. Rosh bet. What's bet? Bet lefi she'ratza le'atchil b'lashon beracha. Hashem starts with bet to teach us that He wants to start the Torah with the language of blessing. Bahachi mekushet tchilat haTorah besofa. Oh, and therefore this is the reason why Torah beginning is connected with the end. What's the last parsha and what's the first parsha? The first is Bereshit and last one is Zot HaBracha. This is where Bracha comes from. This is where the bad Bracha comes from. You don't know where the Bracha comes from? Bracha comes from here. The Torah says, you see bet? That bet goes to the Bracha. Zot HaBracha, connect me together, it says. Why? Because here it talks about Bara Elohim et Emet. Over there it talks about Bracha. Hashem says, do you know when you're going to have that? When you have this. When you have emet, then you have bracha on your head. This is what it means. Sesho shesofa Torah hu v'zot ha-bracha. In the end, where it says v'zot ha-bracha, this is the bracha, means what? Look. He says like this. Bara Elohim et. Emet is in the beginning of Torah. Who says that? David HaMelech says that. Rosh dvarcha emet. And he connects. He says, one second. What Midrash says, why Torah starts with bet? Because it's a bracha, a blessing. So he says, we see Zot HaBracha at the end of the parsha, right? The end of the parsha, we see bracha. In the beginning of the parsha, we see emet. What's the connection between them? Emet we see there. Bet starts Lashon Bracha. Who says Lashon Bracha? It tells you, look back. That talks about bracha. Over there, it talks about bracha. That bracha you will get only if you have the beginning of emet. When you have emet, then you have Zot HaBracha. If you don't have emet, then you don't have Zot HaBracha. You understand? He means to say, you connect them to learn how the bet stands for bracha. And what's the connection? If there's no emet, there's no bracha. Kelomar, lema, lama yitchil bebereshit, bishvil Zot HaBracha. Why Torah starts with bereshit? Because of Zot HaBracha. Omnam. Ala midrash anal. So now let's understand what the midrash talks about. Yesh ledagdek the beperek chet de yoma. In chapter 8, Gemara Yoma says something unbelievable. Look at Hashem's mercy, and look at the Torah value. Hashem's curse and Torah curse. What is stronger curse? Scary, huh? How do we know this?
Because he's the creator of the universe.
I mean. Yeah, but if Hashem curses, he's created. Opposite. If he curses, the whole creation curses. Right? Still Hashem's mercy. How do we know this? By snake. Snake. When something is true, it has two legs or one leg?
Two.
When something is fake, it has two legs or one leg? That's according to us. According to Torah, fake has no legs. How do we know this? He says, after snake lied, Hashem says, why, what happened? Why did the story change? He says, because I lied. Hashem says, yeah? He said, la sheker en la glaim. Since you lied, you have no feet. Lost legs. Now, omnam al midrash anal yesh ledagdek de beperek chet de yoma, because in perek chet in yoma says amrinan tanya amar Rabbi Yossi said in the baraita bo ure, that's in page ayin hey 75 amud aleph 75 first side bo ure, come and see shelo kemidat hakadosh baruch hu midat basar vadam. Hashem is not like people at all. Hashem curses, still there's blessing there. Person curses, there's no blessing there. Torah curses, no blessing there. Why? Adam maknitet chavero. If person is like fighting against his friend, curses him, yoredimo ad lechayav. He goes with him until the end. Until the end. Aval HaKadosh Baruch Hu kilel et hanachash. Hashem curses the snake. Ole legag. If snake goes up the roof, Mezonotav imo. His food is with him already. What Hashem says, wherever you go, your food is with you. One second, you didn't just curse and says, yes, but I still have mercy. Every curse Hashem gives, on the other side there's a blessing. What was the second proof? Gemara brings another proof. Continues with snake. Yored lekarka mazonotav imo. Snake goes down to the ground, his food is with him. Kilel kena'an. Hashem cursed all the Kanaanim. You have Evid Kanaani in the house. Yeah, Kanaani servant. Ochel ma sherabo ochel. Whatever master eats, he should give to his servant the same food he eats. One second. Didn't you curse Kanaani? If you curse Kanaani, why should I give him the same type of food? Let me give him garbage. Torah says, no. In a curse of Hashem, on the side there is a blessing. Veshote marabo shote. If he drinks Snapple, servants drink Snapple. If he drinks whiskey, servant is to drink whiskey. That's the law. That's the law. Whatever he does, he does. Why? Hashem's curse has a blessing in the back. The third one is scary. He says, Kilele Aisha. Hashem cursed woman. Hakolo ratzin acharea. Oh, every man runs after woman. When a person gets married, he wants to get married, he runs after girls. He runs after woman. Why? Didn't Hashem curse woman? So why run after this? That's the bracha. Whenever there's curse, the other side is bracha. Scary. Kilel Adama. Didn't Hashem curse the land? Land didn't listen to Hashem. Remember that? What happened? Hakol nizonin mimena. Every person eats because of the land. One second. If Hashem cursed it, why to eat from this? Don't eat from this. No. Every curse Hashem gave, there's blessing on the other side. Umikan, mashma. From here, we see. She'av mishenit kalel v'yeshlo akalala. And whoever is cursed, and is cursed, he has curse on him. Im kol zeh nishad lo tamid eze tzah tov u'bracha. Still, he has certain good side, and there's a certain blessing behind it. Kmo ha'isha v'anachash v'kena'an v'adama. Like a woman, snake, Kena'an, Kena'ani, and the land. Ume ha'midrash anav, shel lo yeh lecha even v'amen. But Torah says, in Tazriah, you should not have two rocks in your pocket. Why? Because you're showing to a person who buys your merchandise one rock that there's 1,000 grams, which is 1 kilogram. When he wants to buy, you take it and you put 750. So you already steal 250 grams from him. That's stealing. So he says, when a person has that trick, when in this situation, that person who sold the merchandise, he changed the rock. When he gets cursed, lo nishal bo shum tzad tovu bracha klal. Bekasha la ahadadi. When he gets cursed, he gets such a curse. There's no bracha at all here. So it's a question now. How can you say, over there one type of curse, there's certain bracha in it, here curse, there's no bracha in it? So he answers, v'yesh lomar, the answer is, da'amrina beperekama da'avodah zarah, in page 4, Gemara Avodah Zarah, on the second side, says, Torah dichtiv ba'emet. Torah says what? Torat emet. What is that Torah? Yeah. So why Torah would say emet? Even though we know it's emet, Hashem said by Torah emet, why? Torah dichtiv ba'emet. Ein HaKadosh Baruch Hu oseh ba lifnim mishurat adin. Whenever there's an emet, there's a truth, Hashem says, you know what? I'm going here according to the judgment. I'm not going beyond the judgment. Because it's a emet. Like Hashem says, I don't need emet. I could go beyond the judgment. Person deserves curse, I give him blessing on the other side. Torah gives curse, there's no blessing on the other side. So now, Enek Rosh Baruch Hu Oseh Lifnei Mishurat Hadin, by Torah, Din Loketiv Be Emet, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Oseh Lifnei Mishurat Hadin. By judgment of Hashem, doesn't say emet. This is what Hashem could do, Lifnei Mishurat Hadin. Should I read one more time over? To get it clear, yeah? Okay, one more time. Vesh Lomar, the answer is, The Amrinan, Beperek Amad Avodah Zarah, in Avodah Zarah, page 4 says, Torah Dichtiv Ba'emet, by Torah it says, Amen Et, Emet, En HaKadosh Baruch Hu Oseh Ba'lifni Mishurat Adin. Hashem cannot go beyond the law, beyond the judgment. By Torah it says emet. When Hashem judges person, when Torah curses, Hashem cannot go beyond the law.
I'm reading it.
Torah dichtiv ba'emet, en HaKadosh Baruch Hu oseh ba'lifnim mishurat adin. Since the Torah is emet, Hashem cannot go beyond the law. Din, the judgment of Hashem. The locative be'emet doesn't say by the din emet. HaKadosh Baruch Hu oseh ba'lifnim mishurat adin. Hashem could go beyond the law. By Torah, Hashem cannot go beyond the law because there's emet. By judgment, Hashem could go beyond the law because there's no emet. It doesn't say emet there. Va'achi nami hakalalot habaod mikoach haTorah u'mitzvoteha. When the curses come from the Torah and its mitzvot, ein b'shum tzad bracha. There's no side of bracha. V'ha'inu ha'hi shelo yiyeh lecha bebetcha even va'aven. As the way Torah says, you shouldn't have two different type of stones in your pocket or in your house. Omnam, but haklalot shenitkalalu adama venachash veKenan, but the curses that land, snake, Kenan, or woman got cursed, bahu mikoach kenas veonish. Where it comes because of the reward and punishment. There is a law of Torah. A person doesn't keep Torah or mitzvot, he gets punishment or curse. That's a different type. But when person, there's a reward and punishment, Hashem says, if you do it, you get reward. If you don't, you get punishment. In that, when Hashem gives curse, there's on the other side, there's a mercy. Yes, there's two types, yeah. V'hainu, din she'oseh bo lifni mishurat adin. It's a law that, it's a judgment that Hashem does beyond the judgment. Ulchen yesh ba'en na mitzad bracha. And therefore, it has the second side of the bracha. Velashon shel habrachot mibrachot v'akalalot. Velashon shel habrachot mibrachot v'akalalot miklalot. היינו שבמצוות התורה נאמרו עליהן ברכות וקללות בהר גריזים ובנבל, ואותן הברכות מברכות למי שעושה המצווה ומקללות לעובר עליה. So therefore we see here blessing and curses. Person, when he keeps commandments from the Torah gives commandments, if he keeps it, he gets blessing. If not, חס ושלום, he gets cursed. אז זהו מה שאמר דוד המלך עליו השלום. Now we understand what דוד המלך says. Look what דוד המלך says. Generations previous, 2,000 years ago, people, they looked at the letter of the Torah or the word of the Torah, they already saw like a magnifying glass inside everything, like a big highway. Look what it says. Mipikudecha et bonan, from your Hashem Torah, from your Torah laws, I see. Alken saneti kol Oreach Shekel. From your Torah I see, therefore I hate all the paths of Shekel. From the Torah I see, therefore I hate all the paths of Shekel that people go to Shekel way. I hate it. So the Mao et Bonan Umalken. I mean, what did he see? The Matevuna Uma Tam Shaykhka. What's the taste? What are you talking about? What do you see? Halo krokhtiv midvash shekel tidchak. Isn't Torah says somebody lies, run away from there? Lie, run from a lie. Torah says midvash shekel tidchak. I mean, what do you see? From shekel, I see something. Therefore, I hate when people do. What do you see? What is? Maybe he sees the two types of curse. And if person does shekel when he has two rocks in his pocket, and there is two types of curses. When Hashem curses, when Hashem gives curses, on the other side is still blessing. But when the Torah gives curses, when a person has two rocks in his pocket, what happens? Those curses, there's no bracha at all. So he says, ooh, I see from your laws, Hashem, that shekel is fake, it's dangerous. And when you give curses, Torah gives curses, there's no bracha at all. This is why I hate it. I hate shekel. Okay. ובזה יובן מה שאמר דוד המלך עליו השלום מפיקודיך את בונן. From your laws Hashem I see. על כן סניתי כל אורך שקל.
This is why I hate all the pets of Shekel. The Mawetna, Umalken. The Matibuna, Umatam Shayachkan. What are we talking about? What are we dealing with here? Halok, Rak, Tim, Midvash, Shekel, Techak. Isn't the Torah says you have to run away from lie, the odd, and also. It says, you should not deny and you should not lie. Ve'esh lomar. Shebelo ze, hayiti omer. Without this, I would say, she'en tzorech leitlachek kol kach me'orach sheker. I would say, oh, don't run away from fake so much. If you lie a little bit here, it seems like lie here. Well, that's not a big deal. She'are av she'i siman kalala, im kol ze yiyeh bo tzad bracha, kmo anachash va'aisha. Even though I lie, Hashem will give me curse. Then what happens? Okay, I still have blessing. Why? Because look what happened to snake. Look what happened to woman. Look what happened to Kanani. Look what happened to land. Right? Hashem gave curse, there's a, on the second side there's a blessing. Still there's blessing. Aval kshani mitbonen b'mitzvah, but when I look at the mitzvah, said David HaMelech, asher tzivitani lo yelecha even va'aven. You should not have two different stones in your pocket. Shemisham ani lomed shaklalot haba'od mechamat mitzvoteh shel Torah. Hen yoter chamurot. When the curses come from the mitzvot of the Torah, they vary more. The more strict, shelo nishar ben shum tzad tov klal. There's not even one type of gram of good or blessing. Nothing. It's a fully cursed 100%. Again, saneti kol orach sheker. This is why David Amar says, I hate the path of, I say, just or not to be truthful. There is two opposite advisors. Gemarot give us one Gemara Brachot, one Gemara Yoma. Gemara Brachot says, "Lo tiyeh birkat hediot kala be'enecha." When simple give person gives you bracha, shouldn't look so simple in your eyes.
Hediot is simple.
Gemara Yoma says, "Lo tiyeh killat hediot kala be'enecha." The curse of a simple man should not look in your eyes. Why? Then he brings story of David HaMelech and Daniel HaNavi. Why these two people were stuck until David HaMelech got bracha from Aravna, Daniel got bracha from Daryavesh. Okay, they got bracha. Why they got bracha? Because they did certain avera, and that avera got them stuck. So when Hidiot gives bracha, he could fix it. This is talking about when there's klala is not permanent. But when there's permanent klala, and person goes to a tzaddik, who's real non-tzaddik, and tzaddik gives bracha, even though this klala has no way out, because of the bracha of the tzaddik, klala becomes like there was no klala from the beginning.
No way.
He goes to land this way. I was going there. I couldn't continue. But it's so beautiful. First, it shows you the power of klala, how it goes. And then shows you how the tzaddik's power knocks it down. Because this why.
Tzaddik is
emet. Why did I tell you today to learn this? Huh? He's emet. He's connected to Hashem. Why? Because he, Zera Shimshon, knows what he says. I promise whoever learned my Sfarim, I deliver, right? And I guarantee you why he does that. Why? Because when we learn his Sefer, as we say, listen, you be in front of Hashem, Sanigoria, you know? Sanigoria, please speak up for Hashem, like a lawyer. You are our lawyer to talk to Hashem for us. But when he gets there, even though we have 1,000 kalalot on us, it's nullified because he's tzaddik.
Wow.
Do you understand? This is how strong he is. I'm telling you, he goes somewhere very nice. He goes somewhere very deep. Bez Hashem. So we should get connected to Hashem, Bez Hashem. And as we learn Torah, nothing more than to learn Torah. When you learn Torah, everything you want, you don't want. All the averos fly out of you. Bez Hashem, we should
we should get deeper to this, but we continue from this point in Anan Shabbat. For Shabbat, we continue from here in Anan. Okay, and now,